So in this video, I'm going to talk about preparing for the future economy, disruption, and opportunity. So we see another job revolution taking place now and into the coming decades due to industry change, just like we experienced during the Industrial Revolution. However, this one is driven by technology. Exponential technologies like AI, robotics, and automation are predicted to replace many jobs currently filled by humans. In addition, new inventions will make old technology obsolete, and many industries will be digitized and democratized. The McKinsey report states that 15 to 30% of jobs could be displaced by 2030. However, it does not mean that jobs will just simply disappear entirely. They will be replaced by new jobs in new industries. This means that the needs of society will continue to evolve, and those who wish to have success in the future job market must continue to evolve with society. But before we look at what this could mean in your industry or career path, let's look at the good news, which is that we have been through massive industry change before. Human ingenuity and technology is a never-ending, ever-changing dance towards progress and a new way of life. And with each new wave of innovation, old technologies and industries have fallen away. But every single time, industries have died out, new ones have been born in their place. So we have said goodbye to the milkman, switchboard operators, lamplighters, elevator operators, and then later, record manufacturers and video store clerks. I mean, ice used to be the largest industry in the United States. Yes, ice, like the ice cutters they show in the beginning of the Frozen movie. That is, until refrigerators were invented. The ice industry actually spent many years trying to convince people that refrigerators were dangerous in an attempt at saving their jobs. And it's totally understandable, I get it. But aren't you glad that we don't have to store our food in a damp hole in the ground? The horse and buggy industry was another one that had this sort of disruption. It used to be one of the biggest industries in the entire world. And it employed a variety of different types of people. The ones who built and sold the buggies, the wheels and the horse gear, the drivers and repair mechanics, and those who maintained the dirt roadways. Then there were also the ones who bred and reared the horses, ran the stalls, and trained them. And then, within a few short decades, after the introduction of the motorized gas-powered automobiles, the entire horse and buggy industry was completely gone. And now electric cars are doing the exact same thing to gas-powered cars. But we can all agree that we would not want to go back to having our streets filled with horse poo because we're using horses and buggies. So progress always continues, and it's good in the long run. More recently, we've seen the almost disappearance of bookstores, photo film, the postal service, and printing presses. Soon we will see the disappearance of cashiers, truck drivers, parking attendants, gas stations, wired telecom services, and most department stores. But as those industries fade into history, new ones will rapidly emerge, including urban farming, robotics, 3D printing, digital education, information products, alternative energy, and the list goes on and on. So the question is, how will this next wave impact the job market of today? So there are four main ways that technology is interfering with industries and changing them and the careers within them right now and into the future. However, in each of these situations, there are also a ton of new opportunities being created. So the first one is that humans are being replaced, at least to some degree. So when most people think about the changes happening that impact the job market, the first things that come to their mind include robotics, AI, and automation, because it's talked about a lot. And this is the most obvious area for rapid change. And not only manual repetitive tasks can be displaced by technology, intellectual ones can too, like services provided by many in the legal, analytic, and medical fields. In fact, the McKinsey report states that 50% of current work activities are ultimately entirely automatable, and that another 6 to 10% could have at least 30% of their activities be automated. Now, of course, remember, this doesn't happen overnight. But while many jobs that exist today will become less in demand, jobs in these fields are also soaring. In fact, there's a common phenomenon now that companies are having a hard time finding people that are qualified. So think about that. So the second way that it impacts jobs is that new technology makes old ones obsolete. So in the examples that I gave you before about the refrigerator and the automobile, it's a good example of how every new leap forward leaves behind old ways. And sometimes it's super rapid, and other times it takes a long time. So for example, vinyl records have been around for like 100 years. And at first, 8-track technology came and then went, but vinyl stayed. And then cassette tapes came and went, and vinyl stayed. And then CDs came and the vinyl industry finally died overnight. Now, digital music has completely changed the music industry, including dramatically reducing the usefulness of CDs. But the music industry is a great example of how these changes open up new opportunities. While the old way that successful musicians made their money, like through record sales or radio airtime, it's dramatically reduced. At the same time, there's a huge surge of interest in live music events. Even more importantly, YouTube and online digital music sales platforms have made it possible for unknown musicians to monetize even a small following, or even become internet sensations and then end up dominating the music industry. Justin Bieber is a great example of this. This gives musicians a path to success without relying on a small number of highly controlled and competitive record labels that ended up using to control people in these industries and keeping a vast majority of their earnings. And so you can see clearly in music that even though the music industry itself has resisted these changes, in the long run, it's leading to so much opportunity for so many more musicians to get involved. So the third way that this impact is happening is through digitization. So when formerly physical items become available through digital form, that's what digitization is. So think about it. The smartphone in your pocket has replaced the need for CDs, newspapers, books, magazines, cameras, calculators, GPS systems, and hundreds more items that have dematerialized into digital apps. As the need for these physical items decreases, so do the jobs in production, delivery, warehousing, and retail. However, it is no secret that there are opportunities to be had in the digital world. As those objects disappeared, smartphone apps, online stores, programming, information products, and a bazillion other online and digital products became their replacements. And with them came a whole new world of job opportunities. And the fourth way that this impact is happening is through democratization, which is taking out the middleman and putting the means of production and consumption into the hands of the people. So let me explain. The most obvious example of democratization is online marketplaces like Amazon, eBay, Shopify, and Etsy. At one time, all product purchases had to come through brick and mortar stores, middlemen that purchased the product, marked it up to collect their fee, and sold it to consumers. So today, products are more and more being sold online. Since the cost of running online shops is dramatically less than running a store, a physical store, online marketplaces can sell their merchandise at a way lower cost. So no more middleman, at least a less expensive middleman. But not only that, it's not just big corporations that can sell products online. Any person who is willing to do the work to warehouse items in their garage, purchase yard sale items and sell them on eBay, or even create their own custom products can now participate in the buy and sell game of products, which is a huge market. So product sales have been democratized. However, many other industries have been democratized too. So for example, Airbnb has democratized hotels. Uber has democratized the taxi and transportation market. So today, individual people can turn their home or car into a means to make money by offering it to someone who previously could only rent a room or catch a ride through hotels and taxis. And this video you're watching and the online course that it's part of is democratizing education. So today, universities and colleges do not hold a monopoly on higher education. Anyone in the world can learn anything from anyone else in the world, whether that person who's teaching it is a college professor, a business executive, a private tutor, an individual person who's an expert in any field, a hobbyist, or any type of educator, because education has been democratized. So the point of bringing this up is not to express any political, philosophical, or moral argument for or against any of these things. The point is to put them on the table so that you can decide how you would like to proceed in light of this information. So ask yourself the following questions. Do any four of these main ways that technology is impacting different industries apply to your line of work? Would it increase or decrease demand in your industry? And in what way? Can you spot any opportunities for ways that you could shift your career in a direction of these trends that look promising? And so, speaking of looking promising, let's take a look at finding opportunities in the marketplace. So despite what might appear to be increasing unemployment, there are many fields that are actually struggling to find qualified candidates. So one survey through Career Builder of HR people found that the biggest challenge they're having is finding people with the right skills, and that 45% of them have open positions due to inability to find qualified people. So that is really good news for you. So let's take a look at some of the areas that have been predicted to experience growth. So this includes anything from healthcare providers like nurses, professionals such as engineers, scientists, accountants, and analysts, IT professionals and other technology specialists, managers and executives, those whose work cannot be easily replaced by machines, such as educators, especially in emerging economies with young populations, creatives, artists, performers, and entertainers will be in demand as rising incomes globally create more demand for leisure and recreation and entertainment. Builders and related professions, particularly around infrastructure, manual and service jobs in unpredictable environments, such as home health aides and gardeners, and of course, this is just a general assessment based on a variety of reports available at this time. So this will continue to evolve. But what's most important is to stay up to date on changes that are impacting or will impact your industry. So keep your eyes out for those gaps and prepare yourself to fill them. And of course, one way that you can adapt in order to take advantage of new opportunities is to learn new relevant skills. And like we mentioned, there are many new skills in high demand and not a lot of people there to fill them. And the good news, which we'll talk about more in another video, is that the education and training that you would need to pivot your career in a new direction is available at your fingertips, on your own time, and at a cost that you can afford. So none of this is meant to cause you alarm. It's meant to inspire you to look to the future and know that there is a world of opportunity on the horizon. And by the way, if you're interested in learning more, we highly recommend reading the book Disrupt You by Jay Samet and Bold by Peter Diamandis.